So what you see here is different Terraform scripts. So this an example or to create the resource groups. And this is the management groups that we saw earlier, the dev environment policy and the hub and spoke. And this is very simple with Terraform to group objects together. You can see the parent management group ID, and this is the policy. So the policy describes my custom policy. So I can put that in a declarative language, put all my controls, and I can put that in my source control as well. So the scope here is apply that policy just to a resource group, which is the resource group spoke number one. So we expect spoke number one to have the policy applied. So the way Terraform is working, you have to initialize it, and then you have to do a Terraform plan. Terraform plan is tell me what has been deployed and what are the gaps between what I describe here and what is already deployed. So you see there's a data that are being evaluated with different states, and Terraform will tell me everything is all good, no change, your infrastructure is up to date. So if I go to the portal, you can see indeed my two resource group, so spoke number one, and I should be able to see my policy. And bingo, you can see deny IP address is applied and it's compliant because there's no public IP address. So spoke number two should not have the policy, and that's indeed the case, right? So we got the desired state in place. So now let's go to the portal and see what's happening if someone tried to use the portal, so not Terraform, to create a public IP address. So let's select the public IP address, click on create. I'm going to give it a name, so pip for public IP address. One, and I'm going to save the resource group. So if I want to create in resource group number one, regardless of the location, and I click on create, I should have a deny. And you can see here on the validation step, I've got an error, and the error is explicit. It's been denied because of the policy. But what's happening if I'm trying to create the same public IP address on the spoke number two? The validation is successful because I don't have a policy applied to the spoke number two, so I'm able to create the public IP address. So one of the scenarios that we see in the organization, so sometimes policy evolve over time and you may want to apply new policies and you want to be able to track what are the components that are not compliant. So let's say in that case, I want now to apply my policy to this resource group. And I want the policy to be able to report what are the components that are not compliant through the policy. So I'm going to pick up my custom policy created with Terraform, click on select, assign. And now my policy has been assigned. So you have to wait a little bit for the policy engine to evaluate if you are compliant or not. So when you click on it, you can see it is red, not started. But after a period of time, couple of minutes, you will see the policy will be evaluated. And if I come back to my policy, so now you can see 75% of compliance. And I can see indeed, this one is marked non-compliant. I click on it, and I'm able to see the component that is impacted. So that's my public IP address. So that has been flagged. So you can connect that to your alerting. So we'll talk about in a future module about monitoring and alerting, but that's how you can be notified that you got a non-compliant component. So you can do it in an audit mode at the beginning to report the non-compliance. That's a good way to start. And then you can enforce people to remove it. So in that case, if I remove the policy, you will see that the policy engine is going to be re-evaluated. And after a period of time, everything will come back to green. It's a good way to help and educate the architects and developers.